praise you, O Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, thine the glory, revive us.
Is that the cry of your heart? Let's sing it again. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, thine the glory, hallelujah. Glory, revive us again. We praise thee, O God, for the Son of thy love, for Jesus who died and is now gone above. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Hallelujah. Spirit of light, who has shown us our Savior and scattered our night. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Revive us again. All glory and praise to the Lamb that was slain, who has borne all our sins and hath cleansed every stain. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Revive us again. Revive us again. Fill each heart with thy love. May each soul be rekindled with fire from above. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Revive us again.
The Lord wants to do what he did on the day of Pentecost afresh, not in the same physical manifestation necessarily, or even in the emotional way, but in a true moving of his Holy Spirit. And we're going to sing in this chorus, my tongue will be the pen of a ready writer. Will you make your tongue ready to write whatever the Holy Spirit wants to sing through you, wants to speak through you? Not because you want to make a name for yourself, not because you want people to know that you're filled with the Holy Spirit, but simply because you want to be His breath. You want to be His breath. Will you sing this song in faith that you will be the breath of the Holy Spirit, the breath of the Father speaking through the Holy Spirit? Let's clap and sing, Mike.
Hear the sound of rustling in the leaves of the trees. The Spirit of the Lord that has come down on the earth. The church that seemed in slumber has now risen from its knees. And dry bones are responding with the fruit of new earth. This is now a time of declaration. The word will go to all men everywhere. Church is here for healing of the nations. Behold the day of Jesus drawing near. My tongue will be the pen of a ready writer, and what the Father gives to me I'll see. I only want to be His breath. I only want to glorify the King. All around the world, the body waits expectantly. The promise of the Father is now ready to fall. The watchman on the tower all exhorts us to prepare. Church responds of people who will answer
yes,
the call.
Answer?
This is not a phase which is passing. It's the start of an age that is to come. Is the wise man and the scoffer. Before the face of Jesus they are dumb. My tongue will be the pen of a ready writer, and what the Father gives to me I'll see. I only want by the King. Body now prepared by God and ready for war. The prompting of the Spirit is our word of command. We rise a mighty army at the bidding of the Lord. Devils see and fear, for their time is at hand. Children of the Lord, hear our commission. We should love and serve our God as one. The Spirit won't be hindered by division. The perfect work that Jesus has begun. My tongue will be the pen of a ready writer. What the Father gives to me, I'll see. I only want to be His friend. I only want to glorify the King.
Oh, sing with your heart.
My tongue will be the pen of a ready writer. And what the Father gives to me, I'll see. I only want to be His friend. Only want to glorify the King.
I hope those weren't just empty words we sang. I only want to glorify the King. Lord, that's the cry of our heart. And as we enter into this time of prayer, dear brother, dear sister, dear friend, dear children, come and lay your all on the altar afresh. There's an altar in front of you right there where you are. You don't have to come forward or anything like that. It's a secret altar. Only you and the Lord can see it. Or the devil does too. But it's an altar where He's asking you to give up everything, every ambition, goal, everything, every desire that's earthly, every desire that's sinful, every habit that's been hell holding you in bondage. He invites you to lay it all on the altar today. He asks you to lay every part of it from head to toe, your eyes, your ears, your tongue, your heart. What you do with your hands and your legs, your whole body, your ambitions, how you use your mind. Offer your bodies as a living sacrifice. Once you're dead, it'll be too late. He wants a living sacrifice, a sacrifice that's manifest in the everyday things of life. And oh, what joy He will bring. What outpouring of the Holy Spirit. You will see the fire descend on that altar and burn up everything of this earth that will hinder you from attaining the things of heaven. The things of eternity, the divine nature. So lay it as we pray together. Lay it all on the altar. Lay it all for Him. He said, seek first my kingdom and my righteousness. Seek first the kingdom of heaven and its righteousness and all these things that you're longing for. All these uncertainties and doubts and perplexings will be added to you. God will take them away. All the things you need will be added to you. Father, we come to you with that spirit of need and desperation. We come to you, Lord, I come to you honestly saying, I really want to seek your kingdom first. I don't want to seek any other kingdom on this earth. I don't want to seek any other ambition or goal on this earth. I simply want your kingdom, Lord Jesus. And forgive me if I failed where I have failed in not doing that. Thank you that you're on our side against the devil. That's not too late. Now is the appointed time. Today is the day when you will save us. Today is the day when you can save us. Today is the day when you will save us. And we're trusting you for that salvation, Lord Jesus. It's not our sacrifice, Lord Jesus, that makes it worthwhile. It's the altar. You, Lord Jesus, are the altar. And you make the sacrifice perfect and make it holy. So thank you. As we lay our bodies, our lives, our marriages, our homes, our children, their futures, our futures, as we lay it on that perfect altar, which is you, Lord Jesus, we thank you that you will find pleasure in it. It'll be a soothing aroma. More than even the words we sing, Lord Jesus, when you see each one of us in the depths of our heart laying it all on the altar. Oh, we know what joy it brings you. What a soothing aroma rises up to heaven even at this moment as you see the cry of every heart that's willing to lay it all. And so we do, Lord Jesus. Thank you. We pray in the name of Jesus for those who are in a spiritual battle, those in whose life the devil has a foothold. In some ways, held them in bondage. You came to set us free. And free indeed, Lord Jesus, you came to set free the captives. So we pray for any who are in captivity today, in bad habits, in sin, or some other spirit of rebellion. In the name of Jesus, will you come and let your light shine forth through into the darkness, Lord? No matter how old or young they are, Lord Jesus, your light is powerful. You who spoke light into the darkness will shine light into our darkened hearts. You will do that. You've done it for us, Lord, and we ask on behalf of others who are in need. We bring them to you. We lift them up to you, and we believe you will do that, Lord. You will bind the work of Satan. In the name of Jesus, we resist you, Satan, and bind your work. Thank you, Father. We have authority over Satan, and we exercise that. You've given us the keys of the kingdom, Lord, to loose those who need to be loosed and to bind in the heavenlies, and knowing that it will be bound on earth as well. And build your church, Lord Jesus, on the basis of this authority. We humble ourselves. Help us to go deeper, lower in humility, Lord. True lowliness, that's what we long for. That your power may be manifest. Let there be no pride in us at all, not even a little bit. No high thoughts, no exaltation of ourselves. We believe you will do that, Lord. And so in that lowliness, as we take that low place, your Holy Spirit will flow into us and fill us to overflowing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. We believe you will be glorified. We lift up our material needs to you, Lord, but we do them in the spirit of how we just prayed, that we seek your kingdom first, and we know you'll add it. We pray for those that need healing. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray even right now. It's not our prayers, Lord. It's not how loud or desperately we pray, but because we're trusting you. Our eyes are on you, Lord. We don't know where to turn. We've reached a dead end in everything on this earth. Thankfully, we have, and our eyes are on you, Lord. Our hope is in you. You have the answer. You have the healing. You have the power. You have the resurrection life. And that's what we're here for, Lord. We trust you. We trust you for our physical needs. So lay your hands on those that need healing and restore them to complete health, complete healing, Lord. We trust you for it, for our material needs, Lord. Thank you that we don't have to worry. You asked us to live a life that's free of worry. Help us this week that there will be not a single second of worry this entire week. It's possible, Lord. It wouldn't be in your word if it wasn't possible. It's impossible in, according to our own strength, but by your Holy Spirit, we ask for a week this week where there will be not a single moment of worry. Do it, Lord, through your Holy Spirit, a work that's beyond us, a supernatural work. Thank you that we can trust you. We can lay our burdens on you because you care for us. Thank you, Lord Jesus. May you find peace in our hearts in every circumstance and rest. Lead us to that rest, Lord Jesus. We take your yoke upon us, and we will walk with you, and we'll learn from you because you're meek and you're gentle in heart. And we know we'll find rest. Lord Jesus, let this be a week of rest as we seek your kingdom, as we seek you and your glory. Thank you. We praise you for what you will do in Jesus' name. Amen. I'd like to sing the song, Seek Ye First, the Kingdom of God. And as we've sung before, let's do it in a round. So we'll start, sing it together. And then after we go into the chorus, maybe this side of the building with David, Lane, and I will follow onto the chorus, and Alan and Jerusha can lead this side into singing verse 1 again. In that round, let's start together. Seek ye first.
Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Seek his righteousness. All these things shall be.
And all these things shall be added unto you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Things shall be added unto you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Then it shall be given unto you. Seek and we shall find.
Praise the Lord, praise him.
Ask and it shall be given unto you. Seek and we shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord has been speaking to our church recently much about the infinitely Holy Spirit and the holiness without which we will not see our God. Pursue sanctification. Pursue peace with all men and the sanctification, the holiness without which no one can see God. I hope there's a deeper longing for holiness in your life today, dear friends. So take time. Speak often with Him and He will make you holy. Holiness is not something you can accomplish on your own. You can't try harder or do it better. Speak with Him often and let Him impart to you His holiness, the holiness of Jesus.
Take time to be holy. Speak often with God.
Your hands, all of my ambition.
surrender these into your hands. For it's only in your will that I am free.
Are you looking for freedom?
For it's only in your will that I am free. Jesus, all for Jesus,
on the altar
today. All I am and have and never hope to be. All for Jesus, all I am and have, and never want to be.
Put all your plans on the altar.
All of my ambitions, hopes, and plans, I surrender these into your hands. It's only in your will that I am free. For it's only in your will that I am free. Jesus, all for Jesus. All of my ambitions, hopes, and plans, I surrender these into your hands.
Hope you mean that.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my. Save that thou art, thou my best thought, by day or by night, waking or sleeping,
thy presence. Thank you, Lord, you will do it. Riches I give.
my King of heaven, my victor.